and welcome to Time of the Month, my monthly vlog series. Well, this is it, guys. The big one, the last one, the finale. And it is a big one. It's actually the longest one I've made for two reasons. Firstly, it is the last one, and I felt like you guys deserved a little something extra special. Also, I just did a lot of things in December, a lot of things. And even though every episode is as much for me as it is for you guys, I felt like that was even more so the case this month. And I just really wanted to hold on to every memory and not cut too much out. So I hope you guys enjoy it, despite the fact that it's a little extra long. I hope you've enjoyed every episode in the series. I hope you've enjoyed this whole journey we've been on together this year. I certainly have. I'll talk about it a bit more at the end. But without further ado, this is December.
We're gonna fit a 7-foot tree in this.
It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas everywhere you go. Take a look at 5 and 10, glistening once again with candy canes and silver.
This 7-foot tree is going in this. This is actually a big sort of anti-climax.
Thank you.
What I wanted to say, Dan, in all sincerity.
Yeah.
Was that I thought this Christmas might be difficult for me. Emotionally.
Yeah, because of all the...
Because of the
abandonment and...
Yeah.
Stress and...
The heartache.
Yeah, the heartache, all that stuff.
It's really fine.
Why is it fine? What's made you feel that it's fine?
Well, I have friends who'll come put a giant tree in their tiny car and then get through the tree package. And that's lovely.
Proudest of
God bless really us, everyone. Everyone.
Park the hell.
No.
I'm trying to get the spiders out.
She hates Christmas.
Oh, take that, Christmas. What are you thinking of, huh? Yeah.
Rocking around the Christmas tree at the Christmas party hop. Mistletoe hung where you can see every couple tries to stop. Rocking around the Christmas tree, let the Christmas spirit ring.
Dodie, what time is it?
What time is it, Dodie? Go on, tell us. Tell us, I'm interested.
Well, guys, do you really want to know what time it is?
Yeah. The people want to know.
Okay, guys, we'll check your watches. Oh my God, would you believe it's pussy o'clock?
This is really... Oh, no.
Oh,
dear.
No.
Look at that. You're all a bunch of fucking nerds.
Merry Christmas, everyone.
I don't want a lot for
Christmas. There is just one thing I need. I don't care about the presents
underneath the Christmas tree.
I just want you for my own.
More than you could ever know.
Make my wish come true.
So we've just decorated my Christmas tree, who we named Louie, in honour of the guy in the place, who was awesome!
He let Dan go through the thing,
which is amazing. Dan's gone and got a tree. What are we calling her?
Wilbur.
And everyone's here.
Everyone.
Right, what's that one in Star Wars? It's got the thing here, and it's white, and it looks a bit like a duck, and it's like...
It's a stormtrooper, babe.
Why are you asking this?
Because Darcy put on a mask today in Vlogmas, and I wanted to make it my thumbnail and say, Darcy is a stormtrooper, or Darcy's in the stormtroopers. But I didn't want to.
Darcy's in stormtroopers.
Because I just want you here tonight, holding on to me so tight. What more can I do?
Telling him exactly where to put every single bauble.
Because we've got the eyes over here.
It's quite nice to just be over here telling him. It's almost like being on set. It's really nice to just sort of sit back and say, do. Yeah, and we've kind of agreed on most of them as well.
Mm. You're leading. You're definitely leading. I definitely care less.
Oh, it's so perfect. For my Christmas sketch, which is all very last minute. It was just like, hey, let's make a Christmas sketch. And then I call Zach and I said, I need you to produce a thing. And now he's directing a thing and we're here and it's a Christmas sketch. I'm wearing a wig because we're doing a bit of a John Lewis Christmas ad parody. And generally the mothers and those things tend not to have bright pink hair. So I've got this blonde wig on, which looks okay under the hat, but in general has just kind of been the bane of my existence all day. Here comes the man himself. Hello. Oh my God, you're gonna get... Ah! You got me! The disgruntled father in character.
I look ridiculous.
Nice to be back together again, Kai.
Yeah, having a lot of fun.
Being a couple again in a video, we do that sometimes. Yeah.
Doing a lot of making out scenes. They're not going to be used.
The sex scene probably won't make it into the final take. Do you want to say hello to everybody?
Hello! Hi!
This is Stanley. He's the star of the show. The star of the show.
8 plus 8 is 16, kids. Don't forget.
8 plus 8 is 16, kids. Don't forget. Any other truth bombs you want to drop on us?
20 plus 20 is 40.
Yes, it is.
And 100 plus 100 is 200.
That was an easy one.
And 99 plus 99 plus 3 is 201.
All right, Rain Man. That's enough. Every once in a while I call Zach and I say, Zach, I'm
making a sketch. We don't know what it's going to be yet, but if you could just get us a location and a crew,
sort out.
Yeah, I'll write you a script.
I feel dirty. I mean, I feel as if I've done something.
Do you feel like you've cheated?
We shouldn't have done that.
I feel like I'm having an affair, is that?
Oh, line jumps.
Got a fucking aux cable. There would be a massive queue. There's not, but we're at the front of it. I'm gonna get crazy. So here goes nothing. I'll see you on the other side. Reveal ever. Look at the picture Chloe did of me.
she does amazing stuff. She's done them for Dan, Kieran, Jack, Crystal, Elliot,
Dodie,
and Sammy. They're lovely as well. I love Dodie's. And if you want to order one for yourself,
then you should.
You should. And it's you should give Christmas. Her money to do that. Because bills.
Yeah.
First up, we have the writer and director of this film, Mr. David O'Russell, and the star of the film, Jennifer Lawrence. Welcome. All of the characters I've ever played for him have been very big and powerful, but crazy. And this is the first time that we haven't done crazy with me, and she is powerful, but in a quieter, you know, more inward way. I was going to ask you guys to sing, but we'll do that for the movie as well.
Let's do that at the end of it.
And then I go and spoil it all. I seem so stupid, like I love you.
We went to see a screening of Joy with Jennifer Lawrence. I say with Jennifer Lawrence, I mean that she was in the film, but also at the screening, which was cool. The film was good. The film was very good. What did you think of the film?
I thought it was very good. I thought even though it was a bit muddled at times, I didn't really care. I thought that Jennifer Lawrence was outstanding. Like, she always impresses me, but this is like better than she's been before.
She made me angry. She was so good. I aspire to one day be as awesome as her, but know that I won't, but that's okay.
Bye, Dodie.
Dodie Gloop! Causing trouble, Katie. Well, yeah.
Going to Paris?
I'm going to Paris. Are you going to Paris?
I'm not going to Paris.
You're not? Oh.
I'm on the wrong flight.
Quand j'entends chanter Noël, j'aime à revoir mes joies d'enfant.
This is my hotel.
Le sapin,
this is a fucking terrible, isn't it?
Oh,
hotel. That's fucking terrible. Look at this beautiful...
Isn't it gorgeous? This beautiful
then,
that lovely tower, and all Hazel wants to do is nap.
I do, I could do with a nap. I'd have a little nap, I'm not going to lie.
Quand j'entends sonner au ciel, l'heure où le bon vieillard...
Oh my god!
There he is! Oh,
hey.
Thank you!
I mean,
look at it
now. It's the Inception Bridge!
Over there, that's where they filmed it.
Oh.
It's the Inception Bridge.
It's cold outside, and your mother, she waits. We stay and we hide as long as it takes. You'll freeze if you go, so stay here. It's covered in snow, so so stay. It's Christmas and everything's fine, and I've got troubles, I know, but maybe they'll go if I blow them away.
There's the fucking Eiffel. Stop. Thank you.
It's Christmas and everything's fine. And I've got troubles, I know, but maybe they'll go if I blow them away. It's Christmas.
Yeah.
It's that Quasimodo
it's
lad,
so
isn't it?
The Quasimodo.
Quasimodo shit. That hunchback life, son.
I've got troubles, you know, but maybe they'll go if I blow them away.
Flew in from Paris last night. This morning, I'm heading straight back to Dublin, back to the London City Airport. Back to the airport, back to Dublin. Really looking forward to seeing my mother today. She's picking me up. Here we go again.
Yourself a merry little Christmas, make the Yuletide gay.
Just got into my bedroom to discover Helen had left out some new pajamas for me. As we all know, I like pajamas. And I like Star Wars. She's combined my two favourite things, well, pennies have, to create this. Look at this. Look at him. Look at Darth and all the little bloody stormtroopers. And it gets better. There are bottoms. My brother's just called to tell us it's gonna snow. He has this on no good authority, except that he's just decided it is gonna snow. But then we walked outside and I think he might be right. Very incredibly organized women. We're heading out at 4 p.m. on Christmas Eve to do the last minute bits of shopping.
I'm organized.
She has everything wrapped. I don't have anything done, but I have been very fucking busy, to be fair. So
I shouldn't be cursing.
Seriously. Have you seen my channel?
Silent night, holy night, holy night.
Christmas morning, happy Christmas. Okay, my hair is half curled. I am half ready. That's the bishops, giving the elb blessing of a Christmas morning. Helen's making me tea and toast because she's an absolute ledge. And we're on our way to pick up my granddad and then head to my sister's. Happy Christmas, happy fucking Christmas. Ah, hell face. You look lovely. Is your makeup done in the fuck? Right, I'm on it. Like a car bonnet. I'll be ready on time. I'll be ready.
You at it again?
I am at it again. That's a lovely red dress, Helen, for Christmas.
Thank you very much.
Very nice.
Happy Christmas, everybody.
Happy Christmas. These are the scenes currently. This is the less glamorous side of Christmas. Oh, Jesus. Lovely. It's never a white Christmas in Ireland, only just sort of pissy and rainy, really. She's locked us out of the fucking house. I handed her the keys, and I said, I'm getting in the car, bring lock up. She's after walking out of the house and going, where are the keys? I actually don't believe this. I actually don't believe you.
I need something that I can...
You're fucking kidding me, Anna. There it is in the manger. There they are, beside the baby Jesus.
The neighbours don't have keys. I'm gonna get those keys. I'm gonna do this.
Yes! Yes! I'm delighted with that. That's an excellent result. Yeah!
Let's
get the fuck out of here.
Sleigh bells ring, are you listening? In the lane, snow is glistening. A beautiful sight, we're happy tonight. What the fuck?
Where are the people? Who are
you? On the way, here's the bluebird. Here's the day, here's the new bird. Sings a love song as we go along.
Really famous Hazel.
We can build a snowman. Pretend that he's Austin Brown. We'll say, are you married? We'll say, amen. But you can do the job when you're in town. Later on, as we dream by the fire, to face unafraid the plans that we made, walking in a winter wonderland, walking in a winter wonderland.
Now, we are home. We are home from dinner. It was absolutely lovely. So we didn't do our presents, so we're going to do them now. There's only a couple for each other. Firstly, these delightful, festive, fetching socks, which as it happens, I was like, where the fuck did she get these? Turns out they were in my Nana's house. We keep discovering things that my Nana bought and never gave to anyone, yeah. Which is brilliant.
She probably bought them to give.
She probably bought them to give to somebody and yeah. She never did, bless her. But that's lovely. I will like 100% wear them. They're great. Yeah. You know me, I love socks. Brilliant! Why is it 14 years?
Because the small man's was down to your knees and they don't do women's rugby shirts. No.
Helen, that's fucking brilliant! This one?
Yeah, that one.
What have you done? I can tell you're up to mischief, Helen.
You just have one to hang on your wall for every month of the year.
Oh dear, although Johnny, call me.
It's very heavy. Thank you.
Absolutely. Oh god, this just isn't very exciting. It's just molten brown soap,
yeah,
and
no, it's
hand
gorgeous.
Cream.
Yeah. So. And you know what? I'll keep it lit for you.
Always do. Thanks, Helda.
Always keep it lit.
Right. Why? Now it makes. I just saw Monopoly. I was like, why did she buy me Monopoly? It's only fucking Star Wars Monopoly. I'm just taking Jack
through my presence via FaceTime, via the wonders of modern technology.
Jack, tell us about your socks. They're the same socks!
They're the same but the opposite colour.
I've also got a selection box.
Oh, mate!
Yeah, I'll bring that back with me if it survives the week.
What the fuck is that?
That is a fucking rugby jersey.
To scream at the telly in.
Yeah, I can scream at the telly in a jersey now. I've also got a calendar, Jack.
Where's Sexton?
I don't know what month Sexton is, but I'm probably going to keep that one up all year. Could have just bought me a poster. Could have just bought me a poster of Johnny Sexton. It would have been cheaper. I just want a man to look at me the way Johnny Sexton looks at those goalposts. Right. Look who came to visit, it's only Ruby. Say hello. Say hi, Ruby.
No. I mean, no. Never work with kids or animals, that's what they say. My brother's landed on us with his three kids, and they want pancakes, as per usual. Not this one, she doesn't know what a pancake is. Oh! Oh, you're up! Hello. Hello. Got the Wizard of Oz on in the background. We're having a grand old time, aren't we? Yes, we're having a grand old time.
Do you want another one?
Just because I'm presuming that I could be kind of human if I only had a heart.
They're doing my hair.
That's hot.
It's okay.
That's very good, Rosie. Thank you. Ah, well, that's my face.
That's hot.
That hurts, yeah. She's gone. Well, that's been Christmas with Nana Helen. We're on our way to the airport now. There she is, the woman herself. You just drive, you don't be looking at me. a jam-packed yet lazy few days. It's been lovely. Any final thoughts, Ellen?
It's been a great Christmas.
It's been a great Christmas.
Really, really good. Good people, good food, good times. Yeah, and a happy new year to everybody. Bye.
This was number one when I was born.
They recorded this and thought this was good.
Yeah.
Yeah, it is good.
That's not true.
Brilliant.
Look
at that go.
I'm not a fan.
Oh, she.
And Gaga thinks she's all original, does she?
That's the most dad thing you've ever said.
Gaga thinks she's original.
Gaga thinks she's original, does she?
She's not got nothing on Shakespeare.
Ain't got nothing on the Shakespeare sister.
But it's not just the friendship that makes Hazel Hayes' company so fantastic.
From here, it sounds like Dad's pissing. What's going on?
I'm just moisturising.
All right.
Nothing to see here. It's very modern, very progressive.
Oh, hi.
Dan.
Yeah?
Have you any birthday messages for yourself?
It's gonna be fine.
It's gonna be fine, Dan.
I don't.
What age are you now, Dan?
23?
It's 26.
Yeah, I'm 22.
Late 20s.
Don't look a day over 26,
late
20s, do I?
Dan.
I'm exactly
you're 20. Nearly 30.
Mid 20.
Which what? Basically means you're dead. It's very pretty, Dan. Are these the Christmas decorations?
Yeah, these are just decorations for my birthday.
Oh, it's for your. Obviously.
Yeah, that's what
sorry.
It is.
This is lovely. Oh. I'm so sorry.
It's okay, madam. It's happened.
It was him, to
it
be fair.
It was not.
And a if that weren't enough.
I don't know how it happens.
They're gonna have to start adding this into the film.
That's not. That's just.
This is the fourth time this has happened to me tonight. I am not impressed. Oh, you weren't going to get me. I thought you were going to get me a napkin.
Oh, no, no, brilliant. No, no, napkins. There's no napkins.
Of course they're on.
And that's been the evening. I'm having the best birthday.
We're getting ready for New Year, yeah. And I asked Hazel if she was ready. She said yes, she just needed to finish the ensemble with a flower crown, and here she is. Isn't it lovely?
Yeah, so I'm basically...
So she's ready.
I think I'm good to go.
There she is, finished with gorgeous, fluffy slippers. Do a twirl. Oh, look, fashion.
Yeah.
How's that?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Right. Are you making the fort without me? Oh, for fuck's sake!
It begins on it. It's
just casual little fort.
Here we are in the thing. See, it's nice.
It's very lovely.
It's very lovely, like Kira. Well done.
Be a nice chill out space.
Yeah.
For the orgy.
Tell you what, it will be interesting to hammer people here tonight.
To hammer people.
What's it called?
Sex Deborah.
What, this is called Deborah? This is called Deborah. It's in full force.
It's
not a sex fort.
It is though!
It wasn't built for that! It was built for magic and wonder, not dirty sex!
Help on the other side! And it's the cold that it stops! Dire! I'm sorry! Everything I did wrong!
It's like 10 o'clock.
We're talking Dodie,
Stop!
Work it, work it, yes, good, more, bigger!
Last dancing! Your turn!
And I'll write your name always.
Making these. It's my 31st birthday. I'm 31. And I'll probably look back on this when I'm 60 years old and laugh at myself. Started this project a year ago, and I had no idea what it would become, what it would mean to me, or how entwined this series would become with my life. Words are usually my strong point. Whatever else, I'll always have words. But right now they just won't come to me. I want to sum up this year, this series, eloquently and poetically. Words fail me. It's just too much. And You know what? I guess that's kind of the point of this project. Like, I don't have to. Because now I have this rare and precious thing. I can at any point in my life look back on this moment in it. Who I was and how I lived for this small window of time. My relationships, my family and friends, my career, my hopes and dreams, my fears, the good times and the bad. I have it all right here, and that's something not many people can say. And at times it's been hard, as you know, but I'm so proud of myself for persevering with this project. I'm proud of myself for persevering with life, actually, because it's not always that easy, as it turns out. Hazel today is so, so different to Hazel a year ago. And with the help of this series, I can see and feel that every day I'm growing and changing and becoming the woman I'm meant to be. The woman I want to be. And slowly but surely, I'm getting there. I was about to say the thing that I say at the end. And then I realized when I do that, it's all gonna be over. And as much as I wanna say goodbye to this year, I've had some good times too. All good things, eh? Okay. I hope you guys have enjoyed this year as much as I have. Thank you so much for going on this journey with me and for lending me support whenever I needed it. That's been 2015 and that's been December.
Thank you. Okay, this is when you get rolling. Okay. So abrupt. Okay.
And action.
We've had a lot of fun here. In Paris, in time of the month. We followed Hazel's month through the highs and lows across the entirety of 2015. Just gonna have some
Eiffel Towers there, by the way.
Put this bit at the end, like right at the end. Like not even during the Paris trip, right at the end. But I think it's all very important to remember. You know, the real important message behind this series, the reason this series was made in many ways, and ultimately the real thing we'd like you to take away from this series, which is that Dick Cheney made money off the Iraq War. Let us never forget.